We have a long and varied history in our fine city of Norwich, from Boudicca and the Saxons to the Norman invaders to the Flemish weavers to the residents of today. There's been centuries of people coming to live and work in Norwich. And there have been plenty of great Norfolk people who have been number one in their field. The author of the first surviving book by a woman in the English language was Julian of Norwich. Britain's first black circus proprietor, Pablo Fanck, was born in Norwich. And the shortest reign by any English queen, just 9 days in July 1553, was by Lady Jane Grey, who is thought to have been born at Ketteringham Hall. We lay claim to the UK's best-selling cookery writer, Delia Smith, and the birthplace of the lady on the £5 note, Elizabeth Fry. And in 1897, a local man by the name of Albert Coe took the first recorded aerial photograph in Britain from a hot air balloon flying over the building works at Thorpe Station. And Albert Coe was not the only aviation pioneer from around these parts, oh no. The first all-metal aeroplane to be produced in Britain was made by Bolton and Paul in Norwich and exhibited at the Paris Exhibition of 1919. This was followed by the first all-metal biplane bomber called the Sidestrand and named after the Norfolk village, which was taken into service in 1926 by the RAF. And 3 years later, the airframe for the largest airship in the world at the time, the R101, was built by Bolton and Paul at the Riverside Works. Did you know there are only two English puppet theatres, and we have one of them, located in St James's Church, one of our pre-Reformation churches within the city walls? We also claim the first provincial purpose-built theatre in England, the Theatre Royal development of Thomas Ivory, which opened in 1758. And of course, the largest provider of life insurance in the UK. And finally, a quirky number one. We have the UK's only mustard shop and museum. Yep, right here in the Royal Arcade, over 200 years of producing the finest mustards, exported worldwide and renowned for their bull's head. Ah, Coleman's. Well, that's your lot for this episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it. And until next time, I'm Chris Bailey, and I'm at the site of Britain's first shopping centre to be developed with a park on its roof, the Castle Mall.